Now we discuss bounds on put option price. Now if the exercise price is high, we expect the premium to be paid for this high exercise price also to be higher. So if this principle is not adhered to, there is a possibility of arbitrage. So consider two put options. So put option one, exercise price is 100 and the premium you pay for it is 5. And consider another put option, exercise price is 96 and premium you pay for it is 10. So notice that the principle we are talking about has been violated. We wanted this premium to be higher since this exercise price is also high. So the trader will buy P1. So trader is going to buy this put and sell P2. So he will make a total revenue of 10 minus 5, $5. Now if the price drops enough for P2, to be exercised, that the price is say now 90, then the trader exercises P1. He has invested in P1 and he makes further profit from the difference between this 196. So the trader will continue making more and more money. So this is arbitrage. So the trader has zero loss strategy. So he never gets a negative loss. Second is that the difference in exercise price has to be greater than the difference in the premium paid. So difference in exercise price is greater than the difference in the price you pay for the put. Now if this principle is violated, again there is a possibility of arbitrage. So consider two put options. So consider P3. So the exercise price is 100 and the premium you pay for it is 6, and P4, exercise price is 96 and premium you pay for it is 1. So principle 1 is adhered to, but principle 2 is violated. So difference between the exercise price is 4, that is 100 minus 96, and difference between the premium, 6 minus 1 is 5. So 4 is less than 5. So this principle is violated. So the trader now will make riskless profit. So what will trader do? He will sell P3 and buy P4. So he will make a profit of $5, 6 minus 1. So 6 minus 1, $5 he will make. Now if the price is above 100, then both these put options will expire worthless. And the trader will end up making this $5 per share. Now if the price is between 96 and 100, say 96, then the trader has sold P3. So P3 will be exercised. So the person is going to get the stock at 96 from the market and sell it for 100 according to the contract P3. And the trader will lose $4 because 100 minus 96 is 4. But the total gain is, the trader has gained $5 here. He will gain 5 minus 4 is $1. So in fact, for any price less than 96, the trader will always make a gain of $1 because the losses and the gains from the short put and the long put will cancel each other out. And there will always be this gain of $1. And under no scenario, there will be a loss for the trader. So thus the short seller for such an option will always make a loss, because short seller plus long seller has to be equal to zero. And thus there is no such seller in the market.